Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this recital under the auspices of STANZA Festival, Scotland's Poetry Festival. The theme of this year's festival is wild forms of resistance. So we've chosen to interpret wild in a fairly broad sense, because otherwise you'd get lots of songs about how lovely it is to go for a walk in the countryside, whether they be French, in French, German, or English, which isn't awfully exciting for an hour. So the songs that you're going to hear, songs and arias that you're going to hear this afternoon, are to do with wildness of spirit, of mind, recklessness of action or resistance or struggle to the inner wilder person within. First, you will hear two songs from Winterreise, Schubert's song cycle, about a man who is spurned in love and gradually descends into madness and the wilderness that he travels through, both emotionally and physically, is his journey. He talks to trees, he talks to babbling brooks, he looks at crows in the sky. So nature is his friend as his mind descends into emptiness. Then we'll hear an aria from Cosi fan tutte come Scoglio, and this is Fiordaligi standing like a rock, emotionless, battered by the emotional winds and storms of the temptations of infidelity. Then we'll hear two songs by Wolf, Seemanns Abschied and Der Feuerreiter. Seemanns Abschied is a seaman who chooses the wild, fantastical life of marriage to a mermaid, again after he is spurned in love. And Der Feuerreiter is a wild tale of a mythical figure who starts fires. We then move on to William Blake, a set by Benjamin Britten, first year contemplation in the of the fragility and meaning of life. A man compares himself to a fly. And then a rather unhinged contemplation about forgiveness and revenge and the glee of revenge. In My Dreams, from sung by Emily Kemp, is sung by a wild foundling child. And then finally, and I don't want to give too much away about the final piece, but it's Adelaide's aria from The Enchanted Pig. Suffice to say that it is this character's wedding day, and she is not awfully happy about the arrangements. So I will just go and get Brannon Liston-Smith and Claire Innes-Hopkins to perform the first two songs, and every singer will talk to you a little bit about their pieces, possibly give you a little into the translation if they're in a foreign language, so that you know what's going on and what you're about to hear. So I hope you enjoy this afternoon's recital. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this afternoon recital. I'm Brannon, I'm one of the three singers that we have today, and I'm gonna be starting us off with some Schubert. These are two songs taken from his famous cycle, Winterreise, Winter's Journey. And the poems are by a man called Wilhelm Müller. Schubert and Müller never actually met each other, but Schubert discovered these poems and really liked them. And they're very deep. They kind of start off talking about this man's loss of a relationship and his kind of jealousy and hatred towards his ex, but they kind of develop further on into this kind of existential doubt and all sorts of very deep emotions. But the two I've chosen to present both focus a bit more on the kind of vengeful regret to do with his love. So the first one, Die Wetterfahne, the weather vane, describes he's looking at his ex-lover's house and watching the weather vane flit wildly in the breeze, and it makes him think about why she left him for a richer man, and how he's, you know, how he's been discarded. And the second one, he hears the postman blowing his bugle to announce his arrival, and he's wondering, will there be a letter for me from my sweetheart? But there's nothing for him, and he feels, you know, downhearted. And I'd like to ask, can I present these as a pair? So please don't applaud. Well, if you'd like to, until after the second one. Thank you.
My heart, my heart, my heart, my heart, my heart, my heart. Good afternoon, everyone. Over the course of this program, I'm going to be singing three arias about three rather crazy or wild women. And all three of the composers who have written these arias have decided to show that in the music as well as the words. This first one is from Mozart's Cosi fan tutte, in which two pairs of lovers get separated and new people come into the female characters' lives who they don't know are their actual lovers in disguise to try and win a bet. So this particular number, Mozart did not like the woman he was writing it for, so decided to write it to play to all of her weaknesses. So it's very high and it's very low, and there's lots of fun twiddles and runs because she wasn't very good at that either. So I'm going to do my best. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm back with two songs by Hugo Wolf. This first one is called Der Feuerreiter, the Fire Rider, and it's about a German mythical creature, kind of half man, half skeleton-y ghost type of thing, riding around on a horse and setting things on fire for fun or for hell's revenge or something like this. But he's going on some wild ride through the town and setting everything on fire. And it's pretty crazy, as you'll hear, but I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
She's got a much harder job than me in that one. It's really quite crazy. The second song, also by Wolf, is called Seemanns Abschied, or the Sailor's Farewell. It's a sailor singing about how his fiance left him because he wasn't rich enough, in similarity to the Schubert there. And instead, he's going to run off and marry a mermaid and, travel the seven seas riding on the crazy waves. And while everyone else kind of sleeps in their beds, he'll be off to paradise. So, I hope you enjoy this.
For my next song, I will be singing Csardas from Johann Strauss's Die Fledermaus. In this particular song, a lovely, lovely rich lady thinks her husband is cheating on her. So she, instead of asking him like a normal person, decides to go to the party that he's attending in disguise as a Hungarian princess. She then proceeds to sing this song to the entire company of the party, as this character singing about how much she loves her Hungarian homeland.
Thank you.
These are the last of my two offerings, the last of my six. These are the two last of my six offerings. And these are two songs by Benjamin Britten, settings of poems by William Blake, from this amazing cycle, the Songs and Proverbs of William Blake, where Britten took some of Blake's poems and some of these shorter proverbs that he'd written and put them together in a very clever way. I'm singing two, with the proverb and the song that follows it in both cases. And again, I ask if I can present them as a pair. And the first song is A Poison Tree. I'm sure some of you might know it. It's quite a well-known poem, talking of if you really hold on to some vengeful feelings, they can grow and spill out in a very nasty way in the end. And the second poem is The Fly, where contemplating a fly, Blake realizes that, is he so different? What makes him better or, you know, more valuable or, to the world than this fly that he's just brushed away? I hope you enjoy them.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Emily Kemp, and I'm a soprano from Glasgow, currently in my second year of a comparative literature and French degree here at the University of St. Andrews. When I was asked to sing today for the theme of Walk on the Wild Side, there was one song that really stood out to me, and that is In My Dreams from Stephen Flaherty's musical Anastasia. In the musical, it tells the story of Anastasia Romanov, the lost Romanov daughter, and it's really an arc of her journey as she discovers who she is and travels from being an orphan through to Paris, where she thinks that she will find her sense of independence and identity. So yeah, I hope you enjoy.
Drugs all around, it hurries me.
We have come to the last piece in our program today. Adelaide's aria by Jonathan Dove is from The Enchanted Pig, and The Enchanted Pig is a big fancy fairy tale where three sisters and one evil witch's daughter all want to marry an enchanted pig, because if they kiss that pig after marrying him, he will turn into a king. So this is the villain's daughter having a bit of a bridezilla moment about her upcoming wedding to the enchanted pig.